There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full time, celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay. So don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full time, celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full time, celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes.
With that, we welcome you in once again, ladies and gentlemen. We are on the campus of Augusta University. It is the final home game for Augusta here down the stretch. They take on Columbus State tonight before three games in 3 days, the makeup. I'm Jay Douglas, along with Bree Mays, joining me today. You know, y'all have kind of hit a little rough patch late in the season, and just talk to me what you've seen over those games and improvements that need to be made tonight.
What is key for us is starting out strong and staying consistent throughout the game. Coach is always telling us that point one is just matters just as much as point 25. So that is what's key for us, is just being consistent, communicating, and making sure that we cut off long runs. We don't want them to rattle off any more than 3 points at a time. And if they do, we start to dig ourselves into a really big hole that's hard to come out of.
Yeah, y'all have already defeated them once this year, 3-1. They lead overall 4-3 over the past few years. You know, just take me through that first matchup. What do they do effectively, and what can y'all exploit tonight?
Well, you know, I actually wasn't at that game because we were on their site, and I'm not traveling this season. So, but what I can say is, you know, early in the season, we were really strong with communication, and we were just going out and executing effectively. So as long as we see that tonight, that is what we will come out with, a win.
And quickly, a kill for the setter, number 8, Abby King, gets us going. 1-0 Columbus State. Janae Beisner was serving. Well, actually, they've called a violation on Columbus State. So that point goes to Augusta. My mistake. Set by King. Outside McCarty, and it's off the block for a point, and we're tied. Mary McCarty, the kill there, and she actually leads the team with kills coming in. She's got 289 on the season, so give her 290 there. Serving Beisner to Sammy Baker, and Sanderson couldn't get to it. Serving, by the way, number 7, Megan Frame.
We will see an interesting dynamic on the court tonight because this is Sammy Baker's first game back in probably 4 or 5 games, so the dynamic is going to be a little off tonight because she hasn't been able to practice too much this week.
Bickett on a misplay. Bolton plays it over. King sets it to the middle. Baker digs that one out. Beisner to Bolton, and long no touch. Number 18 is Malaysia Stalwart. She tried to kill it initially and was denied. 4-1 Columbus State here early. And Megan Frame continues to serve. And into the net for a service error, and that's kind of what Augusta needs, you know, some easy points, you know, some errors.
Yes, absolutely. You want to force them to make the errors. So as long as we play the ball clean and just execute, we can force them to make all the errors tonight.
King to McCarty on the outside, plays it over and long. Good communication in the back there by Kat and Janae there. 3-3, the score is tied here in set one. And Kat DeSylvester serving, it goes over. Abby King at the net, plays it back, and out, no touch. Well, now they do call a touch, the down ref overruling. Number 18, Malaysia Stallworth, will get credit for that kill.
They're really forcing that line shot and that deep corner shot tonight.
Andrea Skipwer enters the game for Columbus State. Serving is Abby King, the setter. Plays it over Bickett. DeSylvester will get there, and Sammy Baker just going to play it over. King sets back, and yes, they call it good. That was number 24, Skipper, and enters and right away gets a kill. Here's Abby King at 5-3, Columbus State leading. Serve comes over. Jordan Bickett to Sammy Baker. Hendrick on the slide play, off the block and out.
It's a great use of the hands right there.
I see we're going to, you call it, is it 6-2 rotation?
Yes.
That this is?
Okay. Yes, we're running a 6-2 tonight since we do have Sammy Baker back in the game. Gives us a few more options with the front row.
Peyton Murchie, the setter, comes in to serve. Abby King to McCarty, has to dump it over. Murchie tried to get there, but could not keep it up. And the point to Columbus State, and 6-4 is the score. And Mary McCarty will serve at 6-4 here in set one. serving from right to left. Kat DeSylvester to Peyton Murchie to Rachel Wendell. It is blocked back. Beisner's there. Murchie to Bickett and found the hole.
Great swing.
In front of the libero, number 19, Caitlin Merritt. And Jordan Bickett will serve at 6-5 in favor of Columbus State. Serve is in. McCarty plays it to King to the outside. Bickett will dig that one out. Murchie middle for Hendrick, and it falls for a kill. Zoemi Moreto Pereira tried that kill. 6-6 is the score. Jordan Bickett continues to serve here in set one. Serve coming over. McCarty is there. King for Skillpour is blocked. Merritt digs it out. In the middle, blocked again. Merritt Pereira blocked at the net. Hendrick, Murchie for Gonzalez. Good dig by Merritt. Pereira, back row McCarty, and a foul. Violation, I should say.
Looks like they caught a double on that ball. Definitely saw the rotation spinning, so it was a good call by the ref.
The block is pretty strong early.
Yes.
Jessica Hendrick, Rachel Wendell, and Savannah Gonzalez all playing at the net, doing a good job of following where the ball is going, and an unforced error by Jordan Bickett. Serve goes long. It's the announcer jinx, you know.
Always happens.
You praise
yep.
them doing good, and then something bad happens.
Always happens.
Caitlin Merritt, the libero for Columbus State, will serve. 7-7 is the score here in set one. Bickett to Murchie, going to go to Hendrick. Had to dump it over. Abby King is there. To Pereira, it's into the net. It got over somehow. Bickett going to play it to Wendell's, got to play it over. Merritt, King to Skapor, and she got it. Kill for her, 8-7 Columbus State. Columbus State did a good job getting Augusta out of system there.
Definitely.
Couldn't find the ball for Peyton Murchie. Couldn't find it in that point. Here's Merritt at 8-7. Bickett's there. Murchie. For Hendrick.
There we go.
And they call it long, or they call it wide, no touch. 9-7 in favor of Columbus State. It's been a set of runs here early.
Yeah, we got to get a stop and really need to make sure we see the court and putting the ball away.
Murchie to Wendell, going to dump it over. King's there. Merritt's going to set it up to McCarty back row. And Jordan Bickett couldn't get to it. Little miscommunication, it seemed like. And Coach Quarles wants a timeout at 10-7. Interesting timeout there. I guess to just kind of slow things down a little bit.
You know, typically whenever she sees something like that, that was definitely a ball that could be easily gotten up. So she wants to go ahead and call timeout, settle everybody down, and just kind of gather everybody and just make sure that, you know, we're focusing in on the game and anticipating what they're going to do.
Yeah, and in that situation, you know, it seemed like Jordan tried to cut in front of Kat, and, you know, you generally want the libero to get the ball.
Yes, yeah, so that's just one of those communication errors. You got to make sure that you're communicating, calling the ball early. Something that we have been struggling with a little bit is waiting too long to call the ball, so we're having a lot of those miscommunications. So it looks like they're talking it out right now, seeing who was going to get that ball, and hopefully moving forward they're able to overcome that.
Yeah, and you've talked about it's kind of been, I don't want to say bad passing, just kind of timing isn't there,
exactly.
It seems like.
Yeah, you know, we really want to make sure we're keeping the setter on the net. We don't want to have her running all around. And right now, one good thing about Columbus State is they have a very solid serve receive right now. Our serve receive is, it's not bad, but we could better our passes just a little bit more.
So out of the timeout, 10-7, Columbus State leads, and Caitlin Merritt continues the service game here. Jordan Bickett has that one. Peyton Murchie to Wendell. It's blocked, but it falls on the Columbus State side. And Maddie Sanderson checks in. Kat DeSylvester goes out. Jessica Hendrick going to serve. Good use of the block there by Wendell.
Oh, yes.
Here's Hendrick. It's in play. McCarty, King, back to Skipper. And Bickett's able to dig it out. Murchie plays it back row to Hendrick and long. And Hendrick goes out. And Columbus State's going to get a sub in. They bring in number two, Savannah Miller, and she's going to serve. 11-8, Columbus State leads. Serving from right to left, as we call it for you here. Bickett's there. Murchie for Gonzalez touches it over. Abby King to Pereira. Block back down.
Great block. Great block.
Sanderson and Wendell get that one. And here comes Blair Bolton and Sammy Baker back in. Rachel Wendell and Peyton Murchie exit. And Sammy Baker is going to try and get Augusta on a run here. Down two, 11-9, set one. McCarty, Merritt. McCarty from back row. Sammy Baker's there. Jordan Bickett to Blair Bolton. And it's dug up. It'll be a free ball. Sanderson, Sammy Baker, Gonzalez off of Merritt. Can they get there? No. Great effort by Zoemi Ureto Pereira. She's from Puerto Rico.
It's a great hustle by Columbus State right there.
Here's Sammy Baker, able to get it over, but it goes wide. Seems like they want to attack Mary McCarty here on the serve. And now McCarty's moving to the front row on the rotation. And Pereira will go back to serve. Her first serve of the night is way long. So the point that Augusta just gave, they get right back. So
we definitely want to keep the serving errors down. We've been doing a really good job of not having too many serving errors per set, but we want to see a set where we don't have any.
Beisner can attack Miller or Pereira. She attacks Pereira. McCarty with the swing on the outside, and it finds the corner.
It was a great deep corner shot right there.
Can't really fault Janae on that one.
Can't at all.
Good placement and had just enough on it.
Mm-hmm.
Beisner's there. Sammy Baker to Jordan Bickett off the block, and it'll fall out of bounds for a point to Augusta. Number seven for Columbus State, Megan Frame, was serving there, and Augusta gets the side out. Chance to tie it up here on Kat DeSylvester's serve. 13-12, Columbus State leads. And that's a good serve, and it won't get over. Number two, Savannah Miller, overpass and got him out of system, and it could not be saved. See if they go to her again. See where DeSylvester puts it. They go to Miller.
Great serve right there.
Pereira. McCarty gets it over. Beisner's able to dig it out. Sammy Baker for Jordan Bickett. McCarty's there. Merritt, it's got to go over. McCarty plays it over. DeSylvester, Sammy Baker to Hendrick, and it falls. Barreto Pereira could not save it, and Augusta, I think that's their first, no, they got the first point.
Yes, yeah.
14-13, Augusta leads. Here's Kat on the serve. Pereira's there, King, and that is going to fall out of bounds.
Kat's got a really strong serve, so we're definitely forcing them to make some errors right now, which is something we need. We have to get a bigger lead than what we've had. You definitely want to give yourself a nice little cushion.
See, and there you go.
Every single time.
Right in the net. Oh, man. But, I mean, well, you know, we gave up that service error on Sammy Baker, so maybe Abby King, who is the setter, can give it back.
Right.
15-14, Augusta leads here in set one. Jordan Bickett there, Sammy Baker back to Jordan Bickett, and it's out, no touch. Just wide, more than anything.
Yeah, just a little wide. It was a great look, though. That line shot is definitely open.
Here's Abby King, 15 apiece here in set one. Kat will set it up. Sammy Baker or Jessica Hendrick, and she's
great
able to
swing.
Get the kill. It's always nice to have all three options available.
Absolutely.
If you're the setter.
Absolutely, and that's why it's so key to have your serve receive passing really on, because if you don't, then you're eliminating that big middle, and you need those swings.
See what Peyton Murchie does. She gets it in. Pereira, King for McCarty at the net. DeSylvester's able to get it. Murchie going to go to Jordan Bickett. Merritt's able to dig it out. King to Skipper, and it falls in. I'll tell you what, she's done a good job of getting those in the deep corner.
Yep.
I will say Augusta on the serve, they've done a great job of getting it away from Caitlin Merritt, the libero. They've done a great job of that.
Yeah.
You know, Kat's received a lot of serves on our side.
She has.
And she gets another one there, able to get it up, Murchie, and Biggett's got to play it over. Oh, I thought that was going to go long. McCarty plays it anyways. Pereira plays it over and out, and that's a freebie. But Augusta will take it. 17-16, they lead. Janae Beisner exits. Savannah Gonzalez in. Columbus State still has both timeouts. Augusta has one. Bickett into the net.
We've got to figure out the serving.
And Caitlin Merritt going to serve for Columbus State. 17 apiece here in set one. It's been a set of runs, and neither team has really been able to pull away.
Right.
Jordan Bickett, Peyton Murchie, Jessica Hendrick able to toll the block there and get a point.
You know, like you were talking about earlier, you know, it depends on this game where they get placed within the conference. So they're obviously not going to give up right now. They're fighting for that spot for conference right now.
Thought it was 18-17. Skipper with the swing. It's blocked. Nobody there. Murchie looked like initially she wanted it, but then she was going to be ready for the set.
Yeah. And
I'll tell you what, Maddie has come in and done a good job blocking.
Right? Oh, yeah. She's definitely had some really good blocking games here lately.
That's the serve from Savannah Miller. Rachel Wendell, yes, it found the corner. We'll see if Sammy Baker can pad the lead a little bit. Kind of just trading points here.
Yeah.
You know, you get a set like this where teams are trading. Whoever wins it has a lot of momentum.
Exactly.
They're attacking Miller. She's able to get it up, but that one goes wide. Megan Frame missed the swing, and now here comes a timeout for Columbus State. They're down 2-20-18. I'll tell you what, Savannah Miller is the one you need to attack on serve. She's had a really tough time getting the ball in system.
Yeah.
And I'll credit Augusta. You know, it's not easy. You know, it's in your mind, you know, I'm going to serve it to this person, but it's not easy to do it effectively.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You know, you want to hit that person, but sometimes it doesn't always turn out that way, or it goes a little too far left or too far right, whichever. But, you know, Columbus State, I noticed on one of the last serve receives that they tried to hide her a little bit. So they are trying to make up for the fact that she is not passing the ball very well right now. But right now what we need to focus on is keeping our serve in. That's going to be key for us because typically from a timeout, they call it to stop the momentum. So, you know, we need to make sure that we're back there focused and getting the ball in, but still being aggressive.
Yes. And Mary McCarty and Andrea Skipper have four kills each for Columbus State. Malaysia Stallworth one, and I have not seen her a lot in this set.
Yeah.
Jessica Hendrick leading the way for Augusta with four. Jordan Bickett three. Rachel Wendell two. And Blair Bolton has one error. And Jessica Hendrick, two. On the Columbus State side, Laredo Pereira has two errors. Frame, King, and McCarty all with one. Here's Sammy Baker serving at 20-18. Miller's there. King to Frame, and she found it. She found the opening. 20-19. Columbus State, both teams have one timeout, actually. Pereira. Jordan Bickett, Sammy Baker, Blair Bolton. Pereira's there. It's close to the net on two, and it found the hole. Abby King there.
You know, and another thing that we really struggle with in this rotation right here is that Savannah is now on the right side, Blair's on the outside, and they have to make that switch.
They go to Gonzalez here on the right side. She's able to get it off the block.
Great swing.
Come on down, refs. I mean. Yeah, that's something I wanted to ask you. You know, Blair is a lefty.
Yes.
And generally, I'll use the hockey terminology.
Okay.
If you're a lefty, you play on the left side. Is her effective side on the right or
it's
left?
On the right, because they don't have to push it as far. They can set her on the inside, and she'll be able to swing on it. If she's on the outside, they got to push it all the way out past the pin, and that makes it very difficult.
King outside McCarty. Beisner's there to dig it out. Here's Blair Bolton. Merritt's able to dig it out. King. McCarty again. Dee Sylvester's there. Sammy Baker. Going to go to Jordan Bickett. Miller. King. McCarty wants more. Off the block. Jordan Bickett's able to get there. They're going to go to Blair Bolton here, and it's off the block. Pereira's there, but it goes out of bounds. That's a great point.
That's a great point right there.
So she's more effective on the right side then.
Yeah, because when you set it on the right side, with her being a lefty, it's going to be on her inside arm, so on her swinging arm. If you're setting her on the outside, they've got to push it past her right shoulder, out to the pin, and it's not always going to be consistent for her to swing on it.
So Columbus State has called this timeout. They are now out. Augusta has one left. They lead by two here in set one. And I think Augusta's serving. I think we'll have a new server. I think that Columbus State was serving at that last point.
Yeah.
I like what I'm seeing with the block. You know, the times I've been here, that seems like it's been a weak point.
Yes.
I really like what I'm seeing from Maddie Sanderson with the block, you know, Jordan Bickett as well, and Blair Bolton even as well.
Oh, yeah. Last weekend, they had the two of the biggest blocking games I have seen thus far. Both middles, Jess and Maddie, both dominating at the net, and that's what we really need tonight, is to be able to shut down those hitters.
And I'm really seeing consistency because, you know, you take one of the middles out, whether that be Jessica Hendrick or Rachel Wendell, you bring another one in and pick right off where they left off.
Exactly.
Janae Beisner is going to serve for Augusta. Again, Columbus State out of timeouts. Augusta has one. They lead by two here in set one, 22-20. Janae Beisner, here's the serve. Miller.
Great pass.
King for a frame off the top of the block. Dee Sylvester, Sammy Baker going to go to Jordan Bickett. Dumps it over, and it found the hole. Well, there was a good pass from Savannah Miller. I know we've kind of
said she hasn't been doing well,
but she did well there. Beisner attacks her again, gets it to King, to McCarty on the outside, off the block. Dee Sylvester could not get there, and a point to Columbus State. Number seven, Megan Frame, going to serve.
Now the key right here is to cut them off right here.
See if they can get the side out. Beisner. Sammy Baker, Jordan Bickett off the block, and they get it up. I think that's too many. Oh, they let it go. Beisner, Bickett. That is in off of Megan Frame. I know they don't count off the block, but
right.
I thought they hit it once here. That was three. Okay.
It was three. When people start to throw arms, you start to question how many hits, but that was definitely just three hits right there.
My mistake. Set point. Kat Dee Sylvester. King off the top of the block. Dee Sylvester's there. Sammy Baker to Jessica Hendrick. Gets dug out. Merritt. McCarty dumps it over. Janae Beisner there. Sammy Baker. Oh, violation.
Called a double on it.
So Columbus State stays alive. I would venture to say if Columbus State gets the point here, we might see Augusta take a timeout.
Yes.
Here's Abby King, the setter. Janae Beisner, Sammy Baker for Blair Bolton. Had to adjust. Pereira's there. Nobody's there for the set. And set one goes to Augusta. 25-22, they win it. And we will take a break and return with set two. Augusta leads the match 1-0. We're about to get ready to start set two here. Jay Douglas here bringing you all the action. Bria Mays is kind enough to join me on the broadcast tonight. Let's take a look at the stats from set one. The team comparison, both teams had 36 total attacks, Augusta 15 total kills, 12 for Columbus State, 5 errors for Columbus State, 4 for Augusta, 306 hitting percentage Augusta, 194 for Columbus State, 3 service errors for Augusta, 2 for Columbus State, so not a huge differential there. Mary McCarty leads the way for Columbus State, 5 kills, Andrea Skipper with 4, Megan Frame, Abby King, Malaysia Stallworth all with 1. Jordan Bickett leading the way for Augusta, 5 kills. Jessica Hendrick, 4. Blair Bolton, Rachel Wendell, Savannah Gonzalez, all with 2. And Bria, just kind of take me through what you saw in that first set and kind of keeping the momentum in this set.
You know, we definitely winning is going to give us a little momentum going forward. But we need to come out with a strong, might I even say stronger, serve-receive. While we did pick it up more towards the middle of the set, we definitely want to keep those passes consistent so we have options in the front row to be able to run the middle and draw in that block so that it opens up the wings. But, you know, just picking up a little bit on the communication, making sure that those sets are there, and then continuing to be a big presence on the net with the block in the middle. And I think that we'll definitely have a win in this set as well.
So Augusta, of course, winning set one, 25-23. And we're about ready to get started here in set two. Columbus State will serve first. The teams have switched sides. Columbus State will be serving left to right, and they begin with Megan Frame to serve as we begin set two here live on the Augusta University campus. The first serve is misplayed by DeSylvester. It's able to keep the point alive. Beisner plays it over. McCarty for King. Back to McCarty. She has to dump it over. Sammy Baker. Janae Beisner for Blair Bolton. And finds the space between Savannah Miller and Megan Frame. Maddie Sanderson exits. Jessica Hendrick comes in. Kat DeSylvester serves for Augusta. Here's the serve. Pereira to King. And it's a misplay. They wanted number 17, Kylie Bobian, who I think is playing for the first time in the match, and the timing was off there. 2-0, Augusta here in set two. They lead the match 1-0. The serve, Miller to Bobian to McCarty. It's off the block, and again, it seems like Sammy Baker wanted to go for that ball, but it's kind of the setter mindset, you know, I can't touch it.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely need to either go for it or get out of the way.
Here's Abby King, 2-1. Janae Beisner for Sammy Baker to Jordan Bickett. Touches it over, but Merritt's there. King to Skipper. Janae Beisner digs it out. Jordan Bickett one more time off the block. Pereira's there. King in the middle, and another misplay. I tell you, Kylie Bobian is – that timing's a little off.
Yeah, there seems to be a disconnect between the setter and the hitter right now for Columbus State with Kylie in the middle. Looks like that set might have been just a little too high.
And also, you know, it could have been, you know, too quick because,
yeah,
you know, it is a timing mechanism.
Absolutely.
Pereira, that is going to go into the net. They're able to keep
great
it alive.
Play.
Jessica Hendrick, Peyton Murchie for Rachel Wendell. Where did it land? It landed on Columbus State's side. The point goes to Augusta. The combination of Andrea Skipper and Kylie Bobian could not get the block down on Augusta's side. Here's Peyton Murchie serving at 4-1, and that's an ace.
Great serve.
In front of Zumi Barreto Pereira. And a quick timeout. Well, we saw this in set one with Augusta taking the timeout. Mm-hmm. And Columbus State takes the timeout here. 5-1 Augusta leads. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'd like to welcome you back here in set two, Augusta University campus. Augusta leads set two, 5-1. They won set one, 25-23. And I'll tell you, I've seen, you know, the times I've been here, I just see something different about the team right now than the times I've been here. You know, it is late in the season, you know, kind of fighting to get in the Peach Belt tournament, you know, different mentality coming down the stretch here. Mm-hmm. You know, games mean a lot more.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely fighting for it right now. And I think that's the mentality. We're definitely pushing for those wins, especially after being on a losing streak right now.
McCarty had to play that one over as the set was missed. Here's Jordan Bickett with the swing. It's off the block. McCarty's there. King. They're going to go back row to Pereira. Janae Beisner able to get it to Rachel Wendell. King's there. Merritt for McCarty. And long, no touch. Peyton Murchie continuing the service. 6-1 they lead. They lead the match one set to nothing. Here's Peyton Murchie with the serve. And it catches the top part, but it falls back. So a service error there, and that was unfortunate. You know, sometimes you get that bounce and sometimes you don't.
Yep.
Mary McCarty going to serve for Columbus State. They trail the set 6-2. Here's the serve. Beisner able to get there. Murchie for Wendell. It's off the block. Great move by Rachel to use the block there.
Yeah.
And a great up by Janae Beisner. And not only that, I mean, all three components. Janae able to get to the serve.
Yes.
Murchie
yeah.
able to set it. And then Rachel able to get the block and get the kill.
Yeah.
Or use the block, I should say. Merritt to King for Skipper, and Bickett's able to get there. Murchie, it's a misplay, and it's out. Rachel Wendell. 7-3 is your score here in set two. Caitlin Merritt going to serve for Columbus State. See if they can get on a little run here. Here's the serve. Jordan Bickett for Peyton Murchie. Going to go to
that's
Jessica
up.
Hendrick. Gabby King able to dig it out. Pereira's blocked, and it's falling back in front of McCarty. Hendrick and Wendell, I believe, the tandem on the block there. 8-3 Augusta lead. Jessica Hendrick to serve. McCarty to King. To Skipper, and Hendrick couldn't save it.
You know, she tries so hard in the back row, and she's definitely made some improvements from the beginning of the season in her back row and passing and all that. And we just get a laugh out of it every single time she goes back there. She tries so hard.
Yeah, and, you know, it's kind of like, do I play it like she just tried to, or do I do it like a bump?
Yes.
Jordan Bickett for Peyton Murchie. Savannah Gonzalez, McCarty digs it out. It's at the net. No violation there. It falls on Columbus' side. Pereira, DeSylvester, Peyton Murchie for Rachel Wendell. She has to tip it over. Merritt's there. King on two. Murchie's there. Sanderson for Wendell.
Great
and
up.
Miller able to get there. Back row, McCarty. Oh. Long. Augusta's won these long rallies, which is very good for them.
Yeah, absolutely. Definitely staying in there, keep fighting for it. And they're playing consistently. That's what's good is throughout the entirety of those long rallies, they're playing consistently, not really giving up on them.
And what I've seen, it hasn't been stringing together mistakes.
Yeah.
You know, it comes in bunches. You know, one mistake, then a long set of points, then another one. You know, what I've seen, you know, I keep harping on the times I've been here, you know, it's been – you know, mistake after mistake. But
absolutely. No, absolutely.
Cleaning it up a lot.
Yeah.
McCarty, Sammy Baker, Jordan Bickett's going to set it up. And it's close to the net. Gonzalez, she used the block effectively and gets the point.
Mm-hmm.
And that's going to be it for Columbus State. They're now out of timeouts, and it's 11-4. That could be Augusta's strength right there, because now you get on a run, they can't stop it.
Exactly.
And, you know, it could just snowball.
Exactly.
Whereas, you know, they get on a mini run, you have a timeout to burn, and then you use it late if things don't go your way.
Exactly. Yeah, right now what I'm seeing on Columbus State side is I can actually see, like, a breakdown in how they're playing right now. They're not going after as many balls. They're not forcing as many swings towards the back row in those deep corners. So right now we just have to continue to use that to advantage. Their block is weak, so that is playing to our advantage right now, and they are picking up on that.
Yeah, .078 hitting percentage, 10 errors only to 14 kills, mm-hmm. 5 attack errors for Augusta, .286 hitting percentage for them. Digs are even. Augusta has more service arrows. That hasn't really hurt them.
Yeah.
You know, Mary McCarty still leading, 6 kills for Columbus State. Andrea Skipper, 5. And then, you know, Jordan Bickett, 5. Rachel Wendell, Blair Bolton, Jessica Hendrick, all with 4. So it's being spread around more on Augusta's side rather than Columbus State.
Yeah.
So Columbus State now out of timeouts here in set 2, and it's not even half over yet.
No.
Miller to King for Pereira. She had to adjust. Bickett's able to dig it out. They're going to go to Gonzalez close to the net. Merritt's able to dig it out. King on 2. Baker's there. Sanderson and violation.
That was definitely a lift right there. She tried to play the ball up, but definitely when you have those balls and you can't get 2 hands on it, you've got to close your hand. You have to make a fist on it, or they will call it.
This is Pereira. Bickett's able to get there. Sammy Baker for Blair Bolton. Pereira digs it out. King and a miss hit there, but it gets the job done. Baker going to go to Gonzalez, and it's killed out. 12-5 in favor of Augusta. They tried to go to 7, who is Megan Frame on the slide play, and the timing was a little off. Mm-hmm. Now they're going to bring in Malaysia Stallworth for Frame. They keep Savannah Miller in the game. See if Janae Beisner attacks her here. Instead, it goes to Merritt. King for McCarty. She is blocked, but it goes out. And a point for Columbus State. 12-6, Augusta leads. Yeah, Columbus State wants to make a change.
They do. They're trying. But, you know, we just have to continue to be aggressive at the net.
Kylie Bobian comes in for Stallworth. There's a delay here. Here we go. Merritt, Beisner, Baker for Sanderson. She's blocked. Baker's there. DeSylvester for Jordan Bickett. Merritt dig. King on 2. Beisner. Sammy Baker to Blair Bolton. And missed it. 12-7 the score now. And the down ref is, something's amiss here. Something with Columbus State substitution is the problem. The down ref definitely saw something was not right.
I'm wondering if they're calling them for being out of rotation.
They are going to give the point to Augusta here.
Point,
yeah.
Yes.
So what does out of rotation mean?
So you have overlap. So you can have someone who's in the front row come and pass in the back row during serve receive, but they can't be behind those who are in the back row. They have to stay in front of them. And it works like that pretty much all the way around. So it's either that or they had someone who was serving who wasn't supposed to be serving yet.
So that probably could have been the issue because they didn't call it right away
mm-hmm.
when Augusta was, you know, trying to get the point.
Exactly.
So I think Caitlin Merritt wasn't supposed to be serving there.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to have those calls because it's a dumb call to give a point up for.
Miller to King for Pereira. Beisner's there. Sammy Baker to Blair Bolton. Yes.
Great swing.
14-6, and it's a key stretch of points for Columbus State because, you know, out of timeouts, you can't get too far behind.
Yeah.
Here's Kat DeSylvester on the serve. Pereira to King, and that's
wow.
A double touch. They're trying to run that slide play to Bobian, and I guess at the last minute she changed her mind,
mm-hmm.
wanted to shoot it out to McCarty. DeSylvester serving. Pereira. Merritt comes to get it. Here's McCarty on the swing. Beisner gets it. Sammy Baker plays it to Jordan Bickett. Good up by Miller. King, McCarty, Beisner can't get it. Savannah Miller goes out. They bring in Andrea Skipper. And Abby King going to serve. 15-7 Augusta leads. Here in set two, they lead the match 1-0. Janae Beisner, Sammy Baker, it's got to go over. Good job by Beisner to get it over. King to McCarty, and it got in. So, quick 2 points for Columbus State. They try and fight back into this.
Definitely want to get a stop right here, inside out.
Here's the serve. Where's she go with it? She goes to DeSylvester. That's not where you wanted to go, but it was an effective serve. Got Augusta out of system, and now Columbus State's out of system. McCarty, DeSylvester, Sammy Baker, where she goes. Blair Bolton, yes!
It's a great swing by Blair Bolton right there.
I applaud Abby King on that serve. But then when I think it was Janae Beisner played it over, Columbus State wasn't ready to receive it.
They weren't, and which is surprising because you should have been able to notice that that was going to be a free ball over.
Peyton Murchie and Rachel Wendell have entered. That's a tongue twister. Skipper, DeSylvester, Peyton Murchie to Rachel Wendell. Pereira's there. King, McCarty, and no one home for Augusta.
You know, right now they're having to split the back row because with Peyton being setter, she's going to leave a little bit earlier. So they're splitting the back row, and that's going to make it challenging for them to get those deep balls also. If Columbus State continues to kill it on the back line.
That's a great serve, but DeSylvester able to get it up.
Wow, that was awesome.
I'll tell you what, that's gutsy serving it right at the libero, but they are being effective with it.
Mm-hmm, they are.
But Kat's doing a good job, and, you know, you can give credit to Peyton, too, able to set that ball.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Jordan Bickett going to serve 17-9. Augusta leads here in set two. McCarty coming to get it. King. McCarty from the back row. DeSylvester dig. Peyton Murchie for Rachel Wendell. I think that went off the block. It saved anyways. King for number 11. Who is Melissa Murray entering the game for the first time. And right off the bench, she gets a kill. And is there another? Oh, I thought there was another disturbance. Stallworth re-enters. Malaysia Stallworth as number 17, Kylie Bobian exits. And here is Caitlin Merritt. Augusta will take the trading of points. Jordan Bickett, Jessica Hendrick. That's a good dig by King Merritt. From McCarty, tumps it over. Hendricks able to get there, but no one home. You really wish Jessica could have put that ball away.
Yeah.
But give credit to the setter, Abby King, there. 17-11, here's Merritt. DeSylvester for Peyton Murchie to Savannah Gonzalez finds the hole. 18-11, Augusta leads, and they get the side out on that play. I guess it's just if you get the serve initially, but whatever. They get the serve anyways. 18-11, let's see if Jessica Hendrick can put a run together and put this one out of reach. You don't want to give Columbus State any opportunity to hang around. That's blocked at the net.
That's a great block right there. Solid block and straight down.
I think Maddie got that one again. Jessica Hendrick was at the net as well. They tried Melissa Murray again, and she was denied. Murray getting some playing time here in set two. I believe Pereira is out right now. That was touched twice. Free ball, Peyton Murchie to Savannah Gonzalez off the block and in. Great serve by Jess there.
Yes.
To get them out of system.
Yeah.
20-11. Augusta trying to put this one away. Columbus State again out of timeouts. Murray, King for Skipper, and it found the line.
Wow. That was a great line shot right there.
Maybe just clipped it. Savannah Miller re-enters for Columbus State, 20-12. Let's see if she can get a run going. Augusta leads the match 1-0. They lead set 2, 20-12. Jordan
pass.
Bickett, Peyton Murchie, Maddie Sanderson.
Who's up?
Oh, the ref over here said it was down, but wow. Wendell gets the kill anyways. The referee on Columbus State's side signaled to the floor initially.
You know, that's the hardest part is whenever there's a down ref and they try to call that ball, they're going to see that it's on the floor. But when you're looking down bird's eye view, you could see that it hit right off her hand.
That's a kill for Murray, 21-13. Augusta still leading, but don't want to really give Columbus State any hope here.
Yeah, they're definitely trying to fight their way back in this set.
Zoemi Barreto Pereira enters to serve. Kat DeSylvester, Sammy Baker. Blair Bolton just has to play it over. It's off the block. They kept it alive. Over.
Wow.
Sammy Baker's there. Jordan Bickett for Blair Bolton. And it's off of Pereira. It might have gone out if she hadn't played it, but Augusta will take it. They've got some good ups in those last 2 points.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that's got to be demoralizing. You think you have a sure point, and they keep it alive.
Yeah, yeah. It's definitely tough.
Janae Beisner goes to Merritt. King at the net. And I think we...
Caller in the net.
Yes.
Looks like she crossed the play or the line at the bottom, so they're going to call her for that.
Is that the back row attack call? Or
no, it wasn't a back row attack. Her foot went over onto our side of the court.
Pereira. McCarty's just got to play it over. Janae Beisner. Sammy Baker for Blair Bolton. Yes!
Great swing, Blair.
Tell you what, they're riding her a little bit.
Yeah.
And she's on the side where she's effective.
Yes, yes.
This is set point here, 24-13. A whole lot of them. Janae Beisner, Miller, to King, to McCarty outside, off the block. Who's going to get there? Blair Bolton's there. Sanderson on two. It's blocked back.
Wow.
Baker, Bolton one more time. Yes! That will do it in set two. And Augusta has the match lead of 2-0. We have reached halftime, and we will take a break and be back. Augusta 2 and Columbus State 0.
Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band.
think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes. Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes.
Welcome back, everyone. Augusta University campus. We're about a minute and a half away from set three. Augusta leads 2-0. It's time to close it out. And, you know, you don't want to give Columbus State any confidence if they hang around here. But, you know, not really much to complain about. I'm Jay Douglas. Bria Mays is joining me tonight. Not much to complain about through those first two sets.
No, not really. We went out with a lot of enthusiasm, and we were ready to put in work, and that's what they did. You know, definitely in that last set, they definitely tried to shut them down, and I would say they succeeded. So I'm interested to see how this set is going to play out. It looks like Sammy Baker will be returning. Word on the street was she was only playing two sets today, but it looks like she is returning for this set, so that we will keep that 6-2.
And I think that's the luxury right
yeah.
here, because, I mean, you have Sammy Baker, who you said has been out. And, you know, Peyton Murchie steps right in and is very effective.
Yeah.
And they're both freshmen, which is amazing.
I know.
They're able to step in and make an impact right away.
Yeah.
Columbus State, by the way, has gotten their hitting percentage up to .153, 22 kills to 11 errors. Augusta hitting .319, 29 kills to only 6 errors. Augusta has 35 total digs, Columbus State 34. Mary McCarty doing what she does. You know, she came in leading Columbus State with 289 kills. She's added 11. Andrea Skipper came in fourth overall. She has 6. And then you have 3 of Megan Frame, Abby King, and Malaysia Stallworth, all with 1. Mm-hmm. And then on the other side, you look, Blair Bolton, 9. Rachel Wendell, 6. Jordan Bickett, Savannah Gonzalez, 5. And Jessica Hendrick, 4. So a lot more, you know, spreading the ball around, a lot more offensive options for Augusta than Columbus State.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, and it comes down to that passing. You know, as long as we have that pass there, it's going to open up the front row, and it's going to open up those options that we have at the net. Right now, Columbus State, they're getting passes up, but they're all over the place, so they're having to push it to the outside. So they're going to look to that outlet. When they do get the ball on and she's able to run a better offense, they're not really succeeding.
Janae Beisner gets a start in set 3. Augusta trying to go for the sweep. McCarty right away is dug out by Beisner. Sammy Baker to Jordan Bickett finds the hole. And, you know, Blair Bolton came in third on the team with kills, 277. Mm-hmm. She leads the team right now. Jordan Bickett leading the way overall, 293 on the season. Mm-hmm. So your top three kill leaders have been doing what they're supposed to be doing.
Oh, yeah.
They go to number 17, that is Kylie Bobian, and she misses that one 2-0 quickly out of the gate. And I'm telling you, if Augusta can get a big lead, you force Columbus State to use those timeouts, and you get a repeat of what happened in set 2.
Exactly.
And a miss hit there by Maddie Sanderson. They attacked Savannah Miller there, and it was overpass, but Sanderson missed the hit.
It looked like there was a miscommunication between Blair and Maddie on who was going to take that ball. So ended up with a result in the ball going out.
Abby King serving 2-1. Janae Beisner, Sammy Baker, Jordan Bickett. I think that hit off the block. It doesn't matter. It fell in. Or they call somebody in the net. 17, I guess. They called Kylie Bobian in the net. And she leaves. Malaysia Stallworth enters. Kat DeSylvester serving 3-1. Augusta leads. You would really love to close it out right here and not have to play a fourth set.
Yeah.
McCarty, Abby King, back to McCarty. And wide, no touch. That is so hard to see. And the up ref said it was a good call, so Obviously he could overrule if he saw something different. Abby King going to get to that one, and it's just played over Hendrick. Sammy Baker goes to Jordan Bickett. Yes.
Very smart move. Very smart move. She was struggling to get back in position, so that pushing it to the outside and letting her attack where that setter was supposed to be was probably one of the best moves they could have made.
Columbus State has brought in Sabrina Rogers for the first time. Let's see if Kat attacks her. She does. Abby King for McCarty has to play it over. It's blocked back. That looked like that might have gone out. King set for Skipper. She's blocked. And it's out of bounds. 6-1. Just blitzing them right now.
We're definitely getting them out of system, and their setter is just running all around right now. So they're getting a little frazzled.
And that might be an ace, yes. Attacking Rogers. And now she's going to come out, I think. Yeah. Coach Casey Cornett for Columbus State is making that change. They bring in Zomi Barreto Pereira to take her spot. They go to her. King for Stallworth dumps it over. Beisner able to get there. Sammy Baker for Blair Bolton. Ooh.
Touch.
Oh, they did.
Oh.
No. Well, they caught him in the net anyways.
Okay.
Yes, this down ref on Columbus State side caught it out. The up ref has overruled it. 8-1 Augusta in front trying to finish off the sweep here, and it would be a season sweep of Columbus State. King for Skipper, over, Bickett's there. Sammy Baker plays it over on 2. King, Skipper again, blocked.
Oh,
Pereira's there, played over, and out. When does the timeout come? there's been no letdown in Augusta right here.
None
at all.
It's great to see that, too.
Oh.
Every single time.
Well, service error there, you know.
It's okay. We can give them that 1 point, but we just got to make sure we get a stop.
Yeah,
right,
got to
get
the side out right here, not let them get back into it.
Yep.
Here's Mary McCarty to serve for Columbus State. DeSylvester there. Baker for Jordan Bickett, and she's able to get it inside the block, and it lands on Columbus State's side, 10-2. And here comes Peyton Murchie and Rachel Wendell entering. Blair Bolton, Sammy Baker exit. 10-2, Augusta leads. Peyton Murchie serving. McCarty for King, and miscommunication. It's able to be played over. Wendell tried to kill it. It was blocked. King for Pereira, and she finds the hole. Pass Beisner.
That was a great swing for Columbus State, finding those open spots. Right now, we just need to make sure we get this a great pass right here. And first ball kill is huge for us. We don't want them to be able to rally with this.
And a great job by Stallworth to get a piece of Wendell's shot on the overpass.
Yeah.
DeSylvester for Peyton Murchie to Jordan Bickett. Yes, it finds the hole on the cross-court kill. 11-3. Augusta able to get the side out. They serve at 11-3, Jordan Bickett. Serve is into the net.
She needs to make it up with a pass right here.
It's not the end of the world if you trade points. Here's Andrea Skipper. She does pass
job.
It. Murchie, Hendrick, a little timing was off. King to Pereira. That hit the antenna.
Catch.
That hit the antenna over here.
Yep.
They bring in Savannah Miller. Columbus State does. Maddie Sanderson enters for Augusta. Jessica Hendrick going to serve. Kat DeSylvester exits. 12-4, Augusta leads here in set three, trying to finish off the sweep here. Miller, King, Bickett's there. Peyton Murchie, Wendell, and a little miscommunication there. King on two, Hendricks
great
able to
up,
dig it
yes.
out. Savannah Gonzalez blocked on Columbus's side, and Savannah Gonzalez gets the kill. Well, it worked good that time. You know,
yes.
we were saying that just.
Yes, no, she has definitely improved. I'm telling you, she has definitely improved.
See what Jess can do here on the serve. Puts it in play. Merritt, King, middle.
Oh.
And that is blocked on Augusta's side.
Savannah knew she was a little too far off the net on that one, so she wasn't able to really press her hands over the net to block it down.
Jessica Hendrick exits. Kat DeSylvester re-enters. This is Pereira on the serve into the net. And here comes Sammy Baker and Blair Bolton. Rachel Wendell and Peyton Murchie exit. 14-5 in favor of Augusta, trying to close it out in three. Miller, King, that might have been attacking the setter, no call.
Yeah, that was
Bickett,
really close.
Blair Bolton, yes, off the touch of Savannah Miller. No timeout yet. Trying to wait it out as long as she can. Baker, miss serve there.
One too many missed serves. You know, it's okay right now because, you know, we have such a big lead, but it definitely, we're giving them so many points. If they were to make a comeback, it's like, okay, we could have used those 3 or 4 points that we missed.
That's probably the only knock against Augusta in this match.
Yeah.
Sammy Baker for Savannah Gonzalez.
Great
yes.
swing.
And a great set by Baker to even get it to Gonzalez. Savannah exits. Janae Beisner enters, and she'll serve. 16-6. Augusta leads in set three. Beisner, Miller at the net, and that went underneath the net. A point to Augusta. Coach Cornett is trying to wait it out as long as she can. Maybe she's just going right to the end.
I'm thinking that's what it's going to be, because I'm surprised that it hasn't been called by now.
Sammy Baker could not get to that one. McCarty with the kill on that one. Here's Andrea Skipper entering. Abby King to serve. 17-7, Augusta leads in set three. Here's Abby King. Janae Beisner. Sammy Baker for Blair Bolton, but blocked right back down.
It's a great block.
Mary McCarty and Malaysia Stallworth, and maybe Columbus State is figuring out the passing of Augusta. Mm-hmm. Maybe going to Blair Bolton one too many times, but she is your hot hand.
Yes.
Guess you got to take the good with the bad.
Right, exactly.
17-8, here's Abby King. Janae Beisner, Sammy Baker to Maddie Sanderson. She's blocked back. McCarty and Stallworth again.
She needs to run a quick in front of the setter, or she needs to push it to the outside, because right now they are camping out on the right side.
Yeah, I was wondering, like, what to contribute that to. Beisner there. They do go to Bickett on the other side, and she dumps it over. Just what you were saying.
Yep.
Yeah, what I was trying to ask was Sammy being too predictable with the passing?
Yes.
Or, okay.
Yeah. When you go to a certain hitter too many times in a row, they're going to say, okay, she's probably going to go here again.
Kat DeSylvester, Pereira's there. That might have been attacking.
In the net.
I thought that was going to be on Augusta for attacking the setter again, but it goes Augusta's way. I think they called Skipper in the net.
Called the setter in the net. They're passing these balls really, really tight for her to get to them.
Kat DeSylvester, McCarty, King for McCarty. Blocked, but it landed on Augusta's side. 19-10 here in set three. Augusta leads the match 2-0. Trying to pick up, it would be their 7th conference win of the season, and they got 3 left to play, and they'll play 3 in 3 days. That might have been a violation, no call. Hendrick able to get the point. Thought she might have palmed it over. But it's a point to Augusta. They hit 20. And, yeah, Coach Cornette has really seen enough. She's just going to ride it out.
Yeah. At this point, there's not much you can say to change the way it's going right now.
Kat DeSylvester can't get to that one. Malaysia Stallworth gets the kill there. She will exit. They'll bring in number 7, Megan Frame, and you're fine with that. You know, trade points, get the side out.
Yeah.
Up by 9 here in set 3. And I got to say, if this match ends the way, you know, we think it is, with Augusta winning, as Wendell is dug out by McCarty, they push it to Pereira, and she's able to get it off the block and out. I think it sets up very favorable for Augusta to end the season, and, you know, I'll talk about that later.
Yeah.
Still 5 points to get here. Maybe a couple more points Coach Quarles might think about a timeout. DeSylvester for Peyton Murchie and Jordan Bickett. Oh, it worked. Able to dump it over. The soft touch. 21-12 in favor of Augusta. Jordan Bickett will serve. Janae Beisner exits. Savannah Gonzalez in. Jordan Bickett, 4 points away from a match win. It would be their 16th overall. Merritt, King to Skipper off the block. DeSylvester will get there. Peyton Murchie to Rachel Wendell. It's dug out by King. Merritt, back row McCarty. Long, they don't call a touch. 3 points from the match. Trying to close out this win, and it would be, a season sweep of Columbus State. Merritt.
Great serve.
Yes, indeed. King, McCarty. That one was able to fall in.
She was able to finally get on top of the ball instead of pushing it out.
A lot of back row attacks from Columbus State. Not a lot in the front. Skipper, DeSylvester, Murchie for Hendrick. Block. Wendell's there. Gonzalez tried on 2. Merritt to King in the middle. Bickett's there. Peyton Murchie, where's she going? Outside Wendell. And it is a point, a kill for her. 2 points away from the match. 23-13, Augusta leads in set 3. They won the first 2 sets. Set one, 25-23. Set two, 25-13. Jessica Hendrick. Merritt for King for frame, and it found the hole.
Jess was in just a little too shallow on that ball.
Megan Frame gets the kill. We'll do a recap of the stats when the match is over, as well as a preview of the final week. There's a kill, Rachel Wendell out of the middle, and here are 10 match points for Augusta to try and close out this game, this match. Sammy Baker, how about an ace?
That would be nice, right?
Sammy Baker, match point, 10 of them for Augusta. Here's the serve. Merritt, King, they go to McCarty, as they should. She's blocked.
Great
back.
Block.
And that will do it. 25-14, Augusta will take the match and the sweep. It is a season sweep of Columbus State, and that is the all-important seventh win in the Peach Belt Conference. And what I was saying was, y'all have played Lander, Aiken, and Flagler all this year. Mm-hmm. It generally favors the team that lost when you play them again.
Uh-huh.
So I think that it's in y'all's favor these last three matches. And that's why I think it sets up nicely for y'all closing out.
Yeah. You know, I will say this weekend will be a challenge for us. Playing three games back to back to back. And they're all on the road. That's going to take a toll on the girls, especially with them having to go to Florida on a Sunday. You know, we definitely did not want it to end up that way, but their coach was not too friendly about that. So, but, you know, we will push through and we will do the best that we can in executing in those games. Like you're saying, we have played these teams before. Aiken and Flagler are not going to be easy games. You know, we played Flagler this past weekend for senior day. And we were able to take one set from them, and I know they're not going to give up because how pretty they're sitting right now in the conference. Aiken also sitting very pretty within the conference right now. And we lost to them 3-0 the first time we played them.
Y'all have lost 9-2, right? Nine sets to one, those
yes,
three teams?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's going to be a challenge. I mean, I definitely think that we can execute and we can get the job done, but it's really going to take a lot of what we saw tonight, only amplify it just a little bit more. Because, you know, the way those teams are going to come out against us is the way we just came out against Columbus State.
Yeah, and, you know, not much really to take away from the – not negative, at least.
Yeah,
you know, the service errors, again, you know, you want to clean those up
exactly.
in close games.
Exactly.
You know, maybe attack errors came here and there. But like I said before, it wasn't mistake after mistake after mistake.
Which is great.
It was one mistake. We get through, you know, 5-10 points.
Yep.
Then it's another mistake.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was definitely working in our favor, and I hope that we can carry that into the next three games that we have coming up. You know, like you're saying, we got to make sure that we're cutting off those runs. We don't want them to score any more than 3 points at a time. Making sure that those serves, we're cutting down on our service errors, and making sure that we're getting the passes on so that we can open up our offense and have multiple options instead of just pushing it to the pins.
Yeah, a final look at the stats. Well, overall – well, here, we'll do individual. That's fine. Mary McCarty, 14. She came in leading them with kills. No other person on the team had double-digit kills. Andrea Skipper had 6. They had Zomi Barreto Pereira had 3. Megan Frame had 3. Malaysia Stalwart, 2. Melissa Murray, 2. And McCarty hit 205 for her. So, you know, that's really what you expect from your leading kill person. You know, Blair Bolton, Jordan Bickett, both with 11. Rachel Wendell, 8. Savannah Gonzalez, 7. Jessica Hendrick, 5. Maddie Sanderson is the only one that had a negative hitting percentage.
Yeah.
And so that's really good
when
you see that.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. You know, they did a better job of running. They tried to run Maddie on some stuff. They have been working on that in practice. We just got to get that timing, you know, down pat. But Jess had some great kills. Jordan had an unbelievable game today. And making sure she was really getting the roll and tip game going for us, finding those open spots on the court.
Yeah, the last time I was here, she had a rough go of it. I think she had like 8 to 10 errors.
Yeah.
You know, it really wasn't a good game for her. So I was happy to see that. You know,
yes.
I'm happy. You know, if Sammy Baker has been injured, I'm happy to see her back.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And you know, I just think you guys. I mean, I really have confidence that you guys can finish the season very strong. Now, like you said, 3 games in 3 days, all on the road. That is very tough. You know.
Yeah.
Is fatigue going to be a factor?
Yeah. Exactly. You know, it is nice having Sammy back, but you have to think about, you know, we have very limited hitters right now. You know, I'm out. We have Savannah Roy who's out. So that's also going to play a little bit of a factor on it, too. So just making sure that, you know, we make sure we're taking care of our bodies the next few days. You know, icing what needs to be iced and trying to rest when we can, even though it's difficult with school and everything. But
yeah.
That fatigue can set in, especially with it being this late in the season.
Yeah, team stats, 42 kills for Augusta, 31 Columbus State. They had 19 arrows. Augusta only had 9.
Mm-hmm.
351 hitting percentage for Augusta, 147 for Columbus State.
Mm-hmm.
6 aces for Augusta, none for Columbus State.
Wow.
More service errors for Augusta. They had 6. Columbus State had 3. More digs for Augusta, 41-39. More block assist,
mm-hmm.
10-4. And, you know, just everything in Augusta's favor, which you love to see.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. You know, and it's crazy to think that, you know, had that, you know, the hitting errors and the passing errors and all those blocking errors, had they been increased, it would have been a completely different game. You know, but we were able to, even though we had those 3 more serving errors than they did, we were able to execute on everything else, and you have to make up for what you're lacking. So, you know, even though our serving wasn't bad, but we definitely don't want to give those many service errors to them either.
Well, that's going to do it for us here on the broadcast. Again, the remaining schedule for Augusta: at Lander, November 11th, at USC Aiken, November 12th, and at Flagler, November 13th. Augusta now has 7 wins in conference. They are 7-8, 16-13 overall. Lander is 8-8. USC Aiken and Flagler blow 13-2 in conference, so it's not going to be easy, but I really like where you guys are at. So just good luck the rest of the season. It is my last broadcast here for volleyball. You know, I've had a fun time, and, you know, I finally got a win. You know, we won when I'm here, so we finally got a win.
Augusta, all we needed.
Yes, Augusta wins it again. 25-23, win set 1. 25-13, they win set 2. And 25-14, they win set 3. For Bria Mays, I am Jay Douglas. We're saying goodbye from Augusta. Our time is up. We thank you for yours.